So a few white people decided they were going to go to Washington, D.C. and protest about how they don't like anybody but white people. I guess they forgot how many minorities live there. Me and the Notification Gang would like to invite everybody to come join us Monday through Thursday, 9:20 to 10 o'clock for Morning Coffee, where we discuss the events of the prior day and also just talk mess about stuff. See you then.
Hundreds of counter-protesters surrounded on all sides the few white supremacists bold enough to show up for the second Unite the Right rally.
When I first heard that these folks on the anniversary of this murder in Charlottesville, Virginia, were coming to Washington, D.C., I had to say, hell no, not in my town.
Easily outnumbered by the time they arrived at Washington, D.C.'s Lafayette Park, the racist rally wrapped up quickly. As they tried to pack up and leave under police protection, there were reports of minor clashes with the more militant protesters known as Antifa. The far-left group, usually identified by black clothing, tends to be more aggressive toward white supremacists and police. All this back and forth, of course, comes on the one-year anniversary of the bigger Unite the Right rally in Charlottesville. There, counter-protester Heather Heyer was killed when a man alleged to be a white supremacist rammed his car into a crowd of counter-protesters. Heyer's mom spoke from Charlottesville today at a memorial ceremony.
Please remember not to think of Heather, but think of why she was here. She was here to support equality.
BBN, Jack Frost, what's up, party people? Alright, so, I'm trying to tell you, man, these dudes is crazy as shit. So anyway, there was a rally that they were trying to hold. It was supposed to be the second annual, I don't know what it's actually called, but let's just call it, White People Hate Everybody Else That Ain't White Rally. And it's the second annual one. And they were having it in, this year they was having it in D.C., a little bit of backstory for anybody that don't already know about the story. The prior year, they had it in Charlottesville, North Carolina, I believe. And the reason why it was had there was there was a statue of some general from the Confederate Army that the town, it's a college town, and the town had voted to have this statue removed. Right? Because they didn't want it there no more. This is a college town. There's a lot of liberal people that live and go to school in this particular area. And they didn't want to have a statue up of a Confederate general. So they were trying to have the statue removed. They voted on it and everything. After they voted on it, the statue got the clearance to have the statue removed. Before they could have the statue removed, a whole bunch of white supremacists decided that they was gonna go to the area to try to prevent the statue from being taken down. Now, this is just how stupid these people are. And I'm not saying these people like, oh man, all white supremacists are stupid. I mean, I'm pretty sure there's a whole bunch of people who back the white supremacist movement, and they're extremely much smarter than I am. So I'm not saying these people are stupid, but what I'm saying is they're so busy trying to force other people to live the way that they want them to live, they could have did something much more simple. They could have just bought the damn statue out of auction or some shit and then erected it wherever they wanted it erected at and then had their damn get-together there. But instead, they wanted to prevent other people who don't want the statue around from removing the statue so it wouldn't be around. So when they had this white people that hate all other people get together, there was a situation, some people got hurt, it was crazy down there. This one lady got killed because a car full of white supremacists decided to drive through a crowd of protesters, people that were protesting against the white supremacists. It was crazy. And the lady that ended up actually getting killed, she was white herself. She was, you know, because white people hate black people. Please, black people, stop thinking this. At least the black people that think this, stop thinking this. Not all white people hate black people. Anyway, so They decided to have it in D.C. this year. And this makes no sense to me. You see, like, in Charlottesville, there's not that many people. It's a small town. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's a college town. It's not that big. They would have had to... In order to reach the numbers that the white supremacists that converged on that town had, in order to get up to those numbers, they would have had to import freaking protesters from surrounding counties. That's what I'm trying to say. So when these guys decided to go to Washington, D.C. instead, for whatever their reason was, another stupid idea, you know how many blacks live in Washington, D.C.? You know how quickly nowadays... especially older blacks in their 20s and in their 30s are ready to get together and protest if there's the slight chance that they could beat some white racist ass. The slight chance that they could freaking line... Well, them niggas was lining themselves up. If they could possibly whoop a white supremacist ass. I'm letting you know right now, I'm waiting for the protest to happen in New York City where we're going to all get together. I'm just saying. So... they decided to go to Washington, D.C. I mean, for everybody that doesn't know, first of all, the College of Georgetown is in D.C., okay? There's a lot of black people that grew up loving the College of Georgetown, especially if you grew up in the 80s. Do you hear me? D.C. is really, really black. Parts of D.C. is really black. Surrounding areas of D.C. is Baltimore. You know, like... these are the surrounding, don't they call them the VMD or something? The DMV? DMV. Yeah, exactly. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah, but that's Delaware, Maryland, and Virginia. But anyway, that's near D.C. You could drive there. Point being, these white people decided to have a protest in a place that they probably shouldn't have had. They might as well try to come down and have one of them damn protests in Harlem. That was just, it don't make no damn sense. I'm guaranteeing to you, the day that they try to come have one of those protests in Harlem, damn you, a black person gonna call off from work and their boss ain't gonna say shit. I'm telling you. You're gonna be trying to go places, doors are gonna be opening, there's gonna be no employees. There's gonna be whole establishments that's gonna need to close down for that day, because half of their people is gonna show up in Harlem. There's gonna be so many people in, and you know what? If they ever do that, I'm selling water. I'm be selling them shits like $3 a pop. I hope they do that shit in the summer. Anyway, point being, the black protesters that came out, or not even just the black protesters, pardon me, but the protesters that came out to protest against the white people that hate all other races except for their own, they were more than the white people that hate all others except for their own protesters. So that didn't work out for them. And they tried to have, like, a get-together at this one particular spot. They had to get police protection. These badass... I don't even want to call them rednecks, because I know a couple of rednecks that ain't racist. But these badass, swashtika-wearing, Luke and Bo Duke car-driving, Confederate flag-waving, MFers, had to ask for police protection. Because, you know, they're only bad when they have the numbers. When they have the advantage. You know, they're real tough then. Running over women with cars. They're real tough when they're able to do that. Anyway, so that's what happened. They got turned their ass back around. They ain't even taking that in D.C. Wasn't D.C. like the murder capital for a while of America? Like, why are you even going there to start these type of shenanigans? Like, did y'all write y'all wills? I don't get this one. I'm confused. Anyway, let me know what y'all guys think about this. They need to just put that shit to bed. Like, where they going next year? Like, this don't make sense. All I could guess is this. The people who are organizing it know that they have to go somewhere where shit like this is going to happen or nobody's going to care about it. That's all I could guess. They have to go somewhere where there's protesters are going to meet them. Because if they don't go somewhere where protesters is going to meet them, ain't nobody going to know about it. I'm curious, though. Is Trump going to show up, like, after Trump isn't president no more? Is he going to show up at one of these rallies? Because, you know, he think they're fine folk. He's going to show up at one of these rallies. The wind's going to be blowing. His toupee's going to be waving. He's going to be giving everybody aggressive handshakes. It's going to be bananas, yo. Anyway, like, comment, subscribe. Join the notification gang. Hashtag Bronx Ballers. Let's get it. I love y'all. Take care of each other. Hug the kids for me. I haven't forgotten about you. And that's all I got on this one. I'm out. If you like this video, please hit the like and subscribe button. If you would like to help dictate the direction that this channel takes, please leave a comment. All comments are appreciated, whether positive or negative. Thank you very much and enjoy your day. And remember, positive thoughts cause for positive things to happen. Let's get it.